Hi, I'm Janice.
And I'm Jody.
Raising baby dragons to save the world. Saving the world seems like a pretty big task for ordinary people like you and me.
Not for a dragon.
Just for this time together, we want you to imagine a world where dragons live, where all children play on green grass, where women have access to clean cooking fuel right in their own homes, where families can light and heat their homes at absolutely no cost.
Imagine, all this is true.
Allow us to introduce you to how together we can make this happen. We're moms, we're educators, and recently we and several other women have been dubbed the Women of Biogas. We have become part of a growing global community on Facebook called Solar Cities Biogas Innoventors and Practitioners, founded by Dr. Thomas H. Colhane. Over 6,000 members are learning and sharing this technology that we believe is an overlooked technology called small-scale biogas or home-scale biogas. This ancient technology is well known in countries like India and China.
Still, many people have never even heard of it.
We're going to introduce you to your own baby dragon today. But before we do, you'll need to understand the meaning of two words, biodigestion and biogas. Most people are familiar with composting. In composting, we pile up our leaves and our grass clippings and garden waste into one big pile. Then we turn it from time to time to mix air into the pile. It heats up and it breaks down because of something called aerobic bacteria. That's bacteria that likes air. After a few months, we have well-aged compost that we can put on our garden. In biodigestion, we take our manure, our food waste, and our garden waste, and we put it into a closed container. The bacteria inside of this container digests the material. We fill up the tank with water to remove all the air because this bacteria does not like air. This bacteria breaks up the contents of the container within 24 hours, in a day rather than months. The bacteria inside of you, me, and any animal is anaerobic, which leads us to the word biogas. The meaning of the word biogas is much easier to understand. The dictionary says that biogas is a gaseous fuel, especially methane, produced by the fermentation of organic matter. In the relatively new field of permaculture, the biogas is considered one of the appropriate technologies in permaculture design. Now, to bring biogas down to a very basic level, I'm going to illustrate by using a word that you don't typically hear in such a prestigious venue as this. Are you ready? Fart. You knew it was coming. How many of you men, maybe even some of you ladies, lit or knew someone who lit a fart on fire because they didn't believe it would really work? And it did. Well, that is an example of biogas on a very small scale. Your body is a small-scale biodigester. You eat food, the bacteria in your gut digest that food, it creates gas, and you pass biogas. Pretty simple, right? Well, our baby dragon is much more delicate. This is the biogas stove in my kitchen. My baby dragon helps me to cook my breakfast on biogas every morning with a clean blue flame. Can you believe that you can cook meals on poop and food waste? Well, we're going to show you how, beginning with conception. Jody's going to help us put together the basic body parts. What we have here is an intermediate bulk container. Now, these containers are used to ship liquids all around the world. But once they're done with that, they become industrial trash. So we can recycle this trash and turn it into a source of sustainable energy. We first cut a hole in one corner, and then we cut a hole in the opposite corner. Now, what Jody's holding up are called uniseals. They're basically rubber gaskets that create a tight seal with no leaks. We would normally glue these in, but we're not going to do that today. Your baby dragon is going to need three basic sections. She is going to need a mouth and throat. She's going to need an outlet that we'll talk more about later. And then she is also going to need, she's going to spit fire when she's old enough. She's going to spit biogas. So she's going to need an outlet for that too. The gas outlet is basically a combination of pipes and plumbing fixtures that get glued together and then fastened to the lid of the container. Let's take a look inside. Your little embryo of a dragon has a thin layer of stone in the bottom of its belly to create more surface bacteria for more surface area for the bacteria to live on. Next, your baby dragon is going to need some good healthy gut bacteria. So we're going to add a nice thick layer of fresh manure. You can use cow, horse, chicken. You can even use dog or human manure or any combination of those. If you don't have any animals of your own, offer to help clean out somebody's barn.
They will think you're crazy, but they'll appreciate it in the end.
Finally, we add water. Fill a tank with water. Now, we allow this to incubate for 2 to 3 weeks. Once the bacteria has digested what's in the manure, it's going to get hungry, and it's going to look for food, and it's going to hatch.
Congratulations.
You are now the proud parent of a baby dragon, or what we call a Solar City's IBC Biodigester. Seriously, this is how easy and simple the technology is, but this is a living biological creature that needs to be cared for. Caring for a home-scale biodigester is just like raising a baby dragon. The first thing we need to learn about any baby is how to feed her. She has a mouth, but she can't chew. She's just a baby with no teeth. We use an incinerator to grind our food waste with equal amounts of water to create baby food. You can also use a hand grinder or a blender. It works just as well. To feed this baby dragon, we simply pour the food into her mouth. It'll go all the way down to the bottom where this pipe is cut at an angle. There you go. Once inside the belly of the baby dragon, the food will begin to digest. The heavier food at the bottom is going to digest more quickly because it's closest to the greatest number of bacteria. Oils and food that float to the top, they're going to digest a little more slowly. In the middle of the tank is our digested material. Now, we all know raising a baby is all about bodily functions. So keep in mind, her belly is full of water, and what goes in must come out. Yes, your baby dragon pees. The liquid will be pulled up through the hole in that smaller pipe. I guess you can call this section your baby dragon's bladder.
This is liquid gold.
That is our very concentrated and perfect fertilizer. We can use it on our garden. We can water our lawn with it. We even share it with our gardening friends. And unlike composting, our baby dragon is a closed system at the perfect temperature, so this fertilizer has lost none of its nutrient value. And it shows, obviously it shows, because my garden has never been as productive or as green. Small-scale, there are many places that can benefit from small-scale biogas. Our team has chosen three to highlight for you today. Right here in our own backyard of Pennsylvania, a school in Kenya, and a refugee camp in the Middle East. We truly believe that together we can change the world. Imagine giving women the ability to feed their families with clean, free cooking fuel made from manure and food waste. This is Susan. She lives in the Amish countryside in a community that rarely uses electricity tied to the grid. She has a huge garden and plenty of garden waste. She can use that fuel to cook and to heat a part of her home, and she can put the fertilizer right back on her garden. We can empower women like Susan here and around the world to do this in their own backyards.
Imagine that.
This can also be used in struggling communities around the world. This is a picture of Rescue Team Kenya Community School. It is located within an overcrowded labyrinth of tin shacks in a hot climate with no running water and no real toilets. The man in the orange shirt is Robert Ongera Ombika. He lived in the slums. He's self-educated, he got himself out of the slum, and now he goes back every day to change lives. Together, we managed to support Robert in setting up this little school with room enough for 15 students. 65 children showed up the first day he opened the door. There is a powerful desire for education in Kenya, even among the most vulnerable, the impoverished, the orphaned, the hungry, and even the sick. We are all about education. We care about empowering individuals to rise above their situation, but it begins with clean water, food, and sanitation. Together as a community, we managed to bring clean water, food, and school supplies to this little makeshift school. Imagine these children learning how to grow food with the fertilizer they helped to make. Imagine smoke-free cooking in Kenya and around the world. Millions of people, mostly women and children, would no longer die from carbon-related illnesses every year.
With no need for firewood, imagine an end to deforestation.
The village of Chittoor, India did it. They call it the smoke-free village. Every family uses a biodigester. Imagine, no free biogas, no need for firewood, and there's more. Imagine connecting biodigesters to toilets. That would not only provide them with better sanitation, clean cooking fuel, and fertilizer, but would also give them dignity. This is not a toilet that you see here. This is just the safest place for this young lady to relieve herself in Mukuru slum. Our third idea relates to refugee camps. Our first experience with refugees was in 2005 when I became the advisor to a 15-year-old boy from Baghdad, Iraq, who came here as a youth ambassador. We've all seen photos of the refugee camps growing around the world. This crisis has become so severe that the number of people living in this refugee camp alone makes it equal to the second largest city in Jordan. They have nowhere to go. This refugee camp has evolved into a city. This is our crisis. It's happening now. This is in the news today. Mass migration, for various reasons, is real. Camps like this are not going away anytime soon. Imagine clean, accessible cooking fuel for every family in this refugee camp. Imagine how simple a process sanitation becomes when dealing with human waste and food waste right on site. Small-scale biogas is scalable. We can scale it up and we can scale it down. Is it for a small family like Susan's, or is it for a school like Rescue Team Kenya? Or is it for a community like the ever-growing number of refugee camps in the world today? Imagine an end to fracking. This is natural gas. Imagine an end, no concerns about pipelines running through your neighborhood because we create our own energy. We keep our waste. It has value. We turn it into energy and we benefit. Imagine freedom from fossil fuels. Countries like India and Sweden are running buses and trash trucks on biogas. We can too. The possibilities are endless. The rapid spread of this technology could have a profound global impact. What can you do? Go online and learn more about solar cities and biodigestion. Join the biogas movement and do this at home. Share this with your local community leaders and encourage your Department of Agriculture to take a closer look at small-scale biodigestion. Through education, innovation, and outreach, through the help of our heroic baby dragons and a whole lot of love, we can fix our eyes on this simple, overlooked solution to what we now call waste. With biogas, there is no waste. We need you to help spread this gospel of biogas.
This is the sign language for love. It's also the sign we're using for biogas. Inlet, outlet, and gas. Imagine.